Khairat Kelimbetov is Kazakhstan's Minister for Economic Development and Trade. Joins me now from Vienna. Thank you so much for speaking to us. Great to have you on the show. And, you know, before we get to the subject of foreign investment, I actually wanted to start by asking you about oil. We've been speaking a great deal about oil prices in the past few days, particularly in light of the OPEC meeting. So what are your expectations for prices in the coming months? Obviously, your country does very well from oil.
Yeah, you probably know that Kazakhstan produces 1.4 million barrels per day. So it means that we are in top 20 oil producers countries in the world. And in a decade, we want to double it. So any news about the increasing of oil prices is a good news for us. We create special national reserve fund, which is an analog of Norwegian oil fund. And we have over 38 billion reserve money for the government of Kazakhstan. At the same time, we understand that the appropriate price should be sustainable. And we plan our budget between 60 and 80 dollars per barrels. And I think it's a more sustainable price rather than fluctuated between overheating and recession.
Yeah, and I guess that's the concern that many people have right now because, you know, we have seen some volatility in commodity markets, particularly with the price of oil, you know, surging off the back of unrest in the Middle East and then falling back a little bit. How concerned are you about this volatility?
Yeah, you know, we are highly dependent from the prices. So if the prices will be more than $100 per barrel, so it's create an overheating situation, big inflation in Kazakhstan. So that's why we try to sterilize this money into the special national fund, which is under management of central bank. At the same time, so if the price will dramatically down, it could be recession. So yeah. It means that more predictable diapason between 60 and 80 is more, it's like win-win situation for producers countries and for countries who had a consumption.
Sure. So anything over $100 a barrel and you would be concerned. And you touched on inflation and overheating there. Are these issues, challenges that you're concerned about with regards to your country's economy?
Yeah, yes, absolutely. That's why the main slogan of the economic policy in Kazakhstan is diversification of economy, creation of non-oil subsectors of our economy. This is the main idea, to diversify economy in 10 years, to create the new subsectors, so in order not depend just from fluctuation or for changing in oil prices.
And how much progress have you been making on diversifying the economy, on lessening your reliance on oil and gas?
We actually started this program 5 years ago. Was the first stage. We create a special development institution. We find out the particular clusters, which we elaborate together with Harvard Business School pilot clusters. And I think Kazakhstan could achieve a great result, not only in oil, but also in mining and metallurgy, chemical and petrochemical industry. And we are looking for agriculture sector as well. You know, the food security is a big issue now, and Kazakhstan has a great potential to develop the agriculture and food processing production in the future. And we talk a lot about innovation here in World Economic Forum. Is there also great opportunities to transfer technology from European countries? So it's kind of a fair formula. Access to the natural resources at the same time to the European companies, so, at the same time transfer
Mr.
of technologies to Kazakhstan.
Sorry to interrupt you, but I wanted to ask you, it's very interesting, you talk about the diversification program, and I'm guessing that the money to fund those programs will come from the asset sales, divestments, the people's IPO, as you've called them, this plan for the government to offer ordinary citizens discounted stakes in state-owned companies. Can you talk to me about the proposed value of shares that will be offered in these IPOs?
Yes, you know, we are talking about two stages IPO. So first of all, this is a people's IPO. We are talking about we selling some stakes in the national-owned industrial and infrastructure companies starting from the October this year. It will be year 2012 and 13. And I think we are talking about hundreds of millions of dollars. But the next stage, when we will really sell the shares of the big industrial companies, we will talk about billions of dollars. And this will be the very serious IPO programs in the future.
And I I wanted to just ask you a final quick question about food security, something that you touched on in our conversation there. I mean, is this something that you are concerned about? Because, you know, it's not just higher energy prices. We've been seeing higher food prices as well, affecting people, particularly hitting those in emerging economies and developing countries the hardest.
Yeah. We actually are big producers of agriculture production in Kazakhstan. We have a vast geography and we are in top five big wheat exporter in the world. But I think we could improve our technologies and increase our production. And you probably know we are next door to China and India and think they will need our production in the future. And we are working under the niches in their markets and improving our productivity in these terms. So in these terms, the food security is a great opportunity for Kazakhstan to develop the new subsectors of our economy.